Hi guys, it's April and we are back to coloring the clock tower. I want to color in a little bit more of this background, and honestly I don't know where I want to go from there. Part of me, the sky is still driving me a little bit. That's part of me wants to try and fix that. I might see if I have watercolors somewhere. And we might have a little bit of an adventure. But we'll see how I feel when I get to that point. Okay. So I have a few colors that I think it'll take to color in a little bit more of that. I want to kind of pull this line back a little bit. But otherwise, I have those three are for something else. I brought back out the lavender blue, the smoke blue, and the lilac. And I think those three colors will get us that color in the background that we have. And I, of course, will zoom in so it doesn't feel like you're out in the middle of nowhere. I actually think I want to start lightly with the smoke, because the smoke has been giving me the color that I really like the most out of all of this. So it's very interesting that this page, you guys probably didn't see it when I was coloring it last weekend, but it's got this like horizon line thing, and that's kind of what I followed last time. But when you look back at the page, it doesn't really, I mean, it kind of exists, but you've got this fog so much that you lose it. So I don't know why they chose to give it as a line in the actual coloring page. So we're just kind of making that fade. So I'm now using the lilac. I don't want to be too aggressive with the lilac because I don't want to lose the tree. And then I'm going to use this lavender blue just lightly. That we have a little bit of feel of depth, and it pulls it away from that purple of the tree a little bit. Yeah, I'm liking that. I'm gonna bring the smoke back. Kind of bring it all together. And I definitely want to keep these colors out, because what I'm avoiding right here is actually this tree. And so once I actually move to that tree, I have a feeling that I'm gonna want these colors again, because there's some holes in that tree that we might want to sprinkle some of these colors in. So that way it feels more airy, like an actual tree, rather than kind of just a blob. Okay, so right here, in this area right here, we've got this tree-y mountain thing. So it's going to be a little bit interesting trying to get a little bit of that texture, and then we've got that haze as it comes down. I don't think I want the lavender anymore. I might pull it back for a little bit of those highlights. I want to keep at least the smoke gray. So I'll leave the, that was the lilac. I'm gonna leave the lilac and the lavender blue out for a little while. But otherwise I have the white, which is 500. The ash rose, which is 76. Sea fog, which is 476. And then I, of course, I'm gonna keep the smoke blue, which is 379. And if I haven't mentioned it yet, these are all Holbeins. Well, see, I think it's a mountain covered in trees. And by mountain, I mean a very large hill. So, yes. Yes to that question. It is both mountain and faraway trees. Because this, like, hilly part, you can see that there's a change in elevation. And like right here, where it's actually like... I think the mailman got here. The dogs are going crazy upstairs. This is more of a tree in the distance. So you can see the shape more than anything else. I'm going to start with white, just so I can get a little bit of separation and I can very temporarily add in some texture and shape so that you can actually see maybe some structure of these trees. So it might seem a little silly what I'm doing right now. But I promise it'll sort of kind of make sense. So basically I'm creating a little bit of a mask with the white. So that some of the pigment will go down, but mostly it'll be a very muted version of it, which is exactly what I want, because we got this hazy effect going on. I feel like this goes a little bit into this tree. Okay, so now that I have that down, do I want to start with the sea fog? I feel like I want to start with the sea fog and put a base down with that. Because the sea fog is going to create that color difference between that background I just finished and these mountainy tree things. Still keeping it very light because I do want to get some of those other colors in there. I'm going to come in with this smoke blue and I'm going to create some patches of depth. And they're kind of a little bit in line of how I did that white in those fluffy tree shapes. So you can kind of see, now that I've added more color, you can see that white that I put down is taking a little bit of that color, but it's rejecting some of that color. So I can't, it's creating a little bit of barrier, and it's kind of helping me shape what is going on. Then I've got this ash rose, which is going to add some of that pinky color into it that I think is coming from the sun that's just over on this side off the page, which is creating those highlights that I've been trying to duplicate. Going to kind of lightly go over everything. White. Bring back some of this haze. But I also think need to go for all of this with the smoke blue. Because otherwise we're going a little too far on the pink. Looking a little too perfectly formed. And I understand that I'm not going to get this looking like an exact duplicate of the page. But I do want to play around with trying to get as close as possible in whatever form that looks like. Honestly, I don't think that is too horribly bad. wonder if I do have some watercolors. Hold on a second. Like I said, there is... Because of the gouache, I'm getting some of this, like, very interesting texture that I don't know if I really want. You guys can't laugh too hard at me because this is the only watercolors I have. This is from, oh my gosh, 14 years ago when I took a studio art class in college. But in theory, it should still be good. And look at that. I even still have some really super old paintbrushes in there, which I probably will not be using today, but... That's fine. Okay, I need to go get some water, and we will have a little bit of a play. See what happens. This might be an epic disaster, but I want to try it. Let me protect the page beneath. There we go. Let's see. Towels. Okay, so we need the idea is that blue there. I didn't even know I had these paintbrushes. Oh, story of my life. Let's see if I can set up my workspace so it actually makes sense. Okay. I'm just making a mess. It's fine. Might be too thin. But I don't want like a super huge paintbrush. But I don't necessarily want the pointy paintbrush. Okay. So I'm using this angled brush. I think that'll work out. What I want to do. I'm just going to put a little bit of water down first. This is going to be interesting. Okay, we definitely want a little bit of this blue. So that's going to be way too ridiculous. Okay. And then I'm going to do just a tiny touch of purple. And then a lot of additional water. A Okay. Moment of truth. I need to grab honestly, that's not too bad. I know it looks a little well, it's kind of smoothing out the sky in a way that I'm relatively okay with. I will admit, this was just a whim as I was sitting down here to start today. I'm like, I wonder if, especially since we used gouache as a base, if I could smooth some of this down with actual watercolor. Especially that part in the sky that I kept on like tearing apart with the colored pencil. Fascinating. You know what? I think I'm happy with that. And that took way less time than I was expecting that experiment to take. So, that's kind of from a distance what it looks like. And by no means is it like perfect, but it has more of the quality I wanted in that sky and less of that scratchiness. I wonder, do I want to play with fire? I might. This might completely ruin what I was thinking, but since we are here, purple. Blue. Some blue off. More water. Some of this might have too much color pencil. To actually take any of this color. Want to have a little bit of a play. That added a little bit too much like blue right there. I have to find a way to lighten where that color is being eaten a little weird. it's adding a richness that I feel was getting a little lost. Okay. Set that up there real quick. Okay. Use a little bit of the violet. Being relatively gentle. This paper's still a little bit wet. Might want to hold off on that real quick. Nobody panic.
Nobody panic.
That's black. That will end horribly. And I think what happened is I had some Posca there. And so that's why it took it a little bit differently than everywhere else. Now I have.
Wait. Where is my white?
They're there. Have to wait for that. Yeah. Wait for that to dry before I touch that, because got a little too aggressive with the page. Started eating it. That was violet. want. This is the sack blue. Yeah. Okay. That sky looks slightly more alive and vivid than it did like 2 seconds ago. Huh? Kind of my interpretation. Like it. Oh, but here's the next question. Where do we go from here? I'm gonna try not to start singing that song now that I've said that. I need to clean off my desk just a touch. I'm glad I'm not the only one who now has that stuck in their head. Because yes, I am singing the song in my head. And for those of you who do not know, I am a huge Buffy fan. And sometimes, just because I play the Buffy musical episode. It makes me feel better. But I have a very bad habit of just breaking out into those songs. And I want to right now, but I will not. Oh, okay. Do I want it Do I want to start in on some of those trees? In trying to find those colors. I want to clean off my watercolor palette real quick. I didn't use this, so I'm not going to waste that. So I can at least... I'm so glad I still have this. Okay. Close that. Get that out of the way. Okay. Part of me thinks I should just... Yes, it is a mashup. Buffy and Kincaid. Not something you thought you'd see every day. Okay, we'll do this tree. We'll do this tree over here. We'll start with this tree over here. And we'll see how things progress from there. How's that sound? But that means we need to find the color of that tree. I think I want to go with rose. There's a little bit of that purple in there, which definitely going to use the smoke again. Smoke blue. But I need... Do I want to use the violet? I might use the violet for that purple. Of course, rose. Probably going to want a black. Might come in there with the sea fog. And there's like a touch, like the tiniest touch of like green. And I think it's like a tree behind it, but I don't want to lose that. But it's a hazy green. And I'm wondering if I just use the mint green. Okay, so we need what? Rose and mint green? Is that what I said? Yes. Rose and mint green. Mint green, which is 274. And then rose, which is 40. I'm actually going to start with the rose after I sharpen the pencil. Do the same for the mint green. Probably the black. I don't know how much I'm gonna actually use the black, but have it just in case. Okay, starting with the rose. Things, little dots, making it a little bit leprous looking. I suppose I could zoom in for you. I always just feel like it loses some of the color intensity when I zoom in. It's not as pinky back here, so I'm not going to do as much, and I'm going to do it lighter. It's just that there's some very intense spots over here. I'm gonna grab the mint real quick. And mint is mostly just slightly up in this area. Come in with the violet. Feel just gonna do it lightly around here, a little under here. Come back with the rose. Okay, so here is where that smoke blue is going to come in. And then the sea fog. Here, lightly with a little black. Not much. And so we're just going to kind of keep going back and forth. With some of these colors. Like, I don't necessarily want to lose texture of this tree. And I'm okay with this branch fading a little bit into what this tree is, because that is what happens over here. those three down. And I'm gonna do, because I feel like this is kind of the same minty green up in here. But then we've also got the smoke gray again. Mutes things a little bit, and then I'm gonna add a little bit of the sea fog. With this mint green. Grab the white. Next, let me pull that line back. Do I want to grab a slightly more limey green real quick? Ooh, spring green is looking good. Yes. I'm gonna do it. It's happening. Okay, so spring green is 242. Add a little bit more shape to this tree now that we've got that background in. And this is, of course, just the violet. So the tree starts to look a little less cloud-like and a little bit more like there's a series of leaves. I do not mind that is sitting. So that's part of the roof. Anything else I want to do to this real quickly, or do I just want to call this good for today and kind of let it dry? I think this is kind of where I want it to sit for now. Because otherwise, ooh, I have to start pulling out some more color. Ooh, what we could do is this tree over here, because we've got the colors pulled already for it. Okay, let's do it. So this is more of that rose. It will definitely take the black, and we'll do a violet, and then do I want to use... we might use that to blend it all in. So, put a little bit of it up here. Kind of hits a little bit right here, comes down, comes back up. It's got a darkness in this tree. That's a roof line. Don't want to go too far in there. Thank you. There we go. Of course, now that I kind of got that kind of like that, I almost... deep in this tree, just a touch. There we go. That'll make slightly more sense once the rest of the picture is in. Okay, so we went in a direction I actually did not anticipate, but I am thrilled with where we're sitting right now. So, I'm gonna end it here for today. I think my mental capacity for doing more of this page is kind of at its limit for a little while. For sure, I think we're going to come back next time and we're going to continue in with the trees behind the cottage, and then maybe we'll come down the side and start doing some of these bushes and other plants along that. I think that will be a good way to go, and then maybe do the foreground clock cottage. Will probably be the last piece I do on this page. So I want to thank each and every one of you for coming and joining me today in coloring this beautiful, beautiful page. I will be back next week, same time, same place. Eleven Central, my channel. To do more of this, to continue on. I hope you guys will come back and join me in continuing this page. I love that you guys just hang out with me when I do these, help keep my sanity. Otherwise, I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your weekend, and I heart your beautiful faces. Bye.